rush up with nothing. Why the rush up with nothing? Why the rush up with nothing? Making it to the playoffs is one thing, but that's when the pressure really sets in. Because for us and our fans, there's only one acceptable outcome. A win on Super Bowl Sunday. Losing him was a major blow to our playbook, but we wouldn't find out just how much of an advantage it was to our opponents until we were actually facing them.
Today, from Empower Field at Mile High in Denver, it's the AFC Divisional Round Playoffs on EA Sports. Broncos taking on the Kansas City Chiefs.
As far as home field advantages go in the playoffs, there are few places tougher on a visiting team than this one. Sold out in Power Field at Mile High in Denver.
Coming up, it's divisional round Saturday, and we've got an AFC battle on tap between the Kansas City Chiefs and the Denver Broncos.
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
A.J. Handler on the
So here are the Broncos now for their opening drive. And a glance at the tall signal caller, standing 6'6".
In playoff games in and of themselves, we know they're pressure-filled. That's not breaking any news. But you have to wonder how much added pressure this team feels, given that a perfect season is on the line. They heard it during the regular season. Now they've sat at home for 2 weeks hearing about it. Can they handle that as well as the team that they're facing in order to try and advance?
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And lucky to get away with one there. That one nearly picked. Second down. From the 21, it's second and 10. The pass there complete to Sutton. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. That's good for a first down. There's a guy who went over 1,000 yards receiving in the regular season, and now he's got his first catch in the playoffs. So, Charles, here we are in the playoffs, and this rookie quarterback, likely a front runner for Offensive Rookie of the Year, but he's not too concerned about that. He was all business with us, saying, I just want to advance to the playoffs.
And what's really nice for him is that it's a home game, which means routine doesn't really get jarred, does it? He can do the same thing he's been doing throughout the regular season. What worked for him, how he gets ready and prepared, it's an easier path for him, although playing the game will not be, because the playoffs, the pressure cooker is big.
He certainly did play well in the regular season, division title under his belt as a rookie, and you're right. Look, it's nice to have the home fans cheering for you as opposed to having to go on the road and getting those boos. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down.
Taken
a gain of three, second down.
It's a pickup of three. Brings up second and seven.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Forced out to his left. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down. So first and 10 now from the 30. Now Gordon on first down. And he's got Rome. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Melvin Gordon, 30 yards. And the Broncos take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Oh,
remember
yeah.
what he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result, but he opted for the touchback. The KC offense set to go, led as always by the gunslinger, a former MVP in this league. It's Patrick Mahomes.
It wasn't really his best performance of the year in the wild card round last week. He just had the one touchdown pass, but he got the job done and his team advanced. For them to continue on to the championship round, though, and he's going to need to take a few more chances with the ball downfield, push it a little bit more, and make sure his team finds its way into the end zone a few more times.
Now a pass that's taken in by Hill. Hill's hit, and he lost the football. It's picked up by the Broncos. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line.
Thank goodness for heaters up here. And thank goodness I don't have to carry the football in this game. It's January. It's cold out there. Trying to clutch the football and absorb the hits. Not easily done.
Yeah, we saw a product of the elements right there. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down. A good throw right there by the rookie. Charles, if you're looking at things that he needs to do to be successful in the playoffs, what would you say?
I'd say that his team, in designing what they're going to do, play to his strengths. Get him comfortable early. Let him make the kind of throws that are most effective for him. But you'll have to dress it up a little bit differently. Otherwise, they've seen all of this. They've scouted it. So maybe you show the formations a little bit different and get back to your basic plays.
Got a man. It's Judy complete. And they work this near the five. He'll be stopped at the six. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, and it's good for a first down as well. First and goal, Melvin Gordon. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the five down to the three.
Derek has already scored once. He definitely had his eyes wide open trying to get in there a second time, but thought that was a really nice play defensively.
And he will fight his way into the end zone for a Bronco touchdown. Melvin Gordon with his second touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. And a pair of rushing touchdowns now for him in the first quarter.
And I'm liking what I'm seeing from his big guys up front because they're winning the leverage game. How many times have we talked about? Low man wins, right? Move the defensive front aside, create those gaps and holes. He's found his way through them for two touchdowns.
And after both of those touchdowns, he went right up to that O-line and hit each of them on the helmet.
That's a smart man. You know what else he should do? If this continues, take them all to dinner.
The Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive, and they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
They're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up.
Here a throw taken in by Watkins. His first catch of the divisional round goes for a first down. He had five catches last week in their wild card win. So from the 36 now, first and 10. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Chiefs nothing.
Off the draw, here's Williams. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give him 15 yards on that one. Kansas City has a first down. So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 49-yard line. Oh, he's got a little daylight. The 20. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And this is going to kick out of bounds. Boy, a fortunate bounce or two there. They'll keep possession back inside the 10-yard line. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal.
Tremaine Johnson. Patrick Mahomes.
And their inaugural sack of the game coming from an unlikely source.
You mean it wasn't a linebacker? It wasn't a defensive end?
It was somebody like you.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, that's a surprise for the offense. That's not what they normally get when they think about pressure.
And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Only a couple yards there. And that's going to set up a long third and goal. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Here's Mahomes to throw. And he'll go down. Brought down at the 20-yard line. Von Miller with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of 7.
That's quite a stand there defensively. A huge sack on third down. And that's going to force him into a field goal attempt.
Butker's kick here is good, and they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3.
14.
Now, that's something of a pick-me-up, and the offense certainly has struggled, but they do get the field goal before half to put 3 on the board.
Yeah, you don't want to be shut out, but let's face it, those 3 points, that's not going to solve all their problems either.
And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
Broncos take over first and 10.
Melvin Gordon now, he and the offense, they trot back out there. And we get a glance here, Charles, at his 2 touchdown runs.
And partner, have you ever noticed that when someone scores a second time, they have a little bit of extra pep in their step? It's always, you know, they're always fired up to score. But when you get in twice, it's almost like they're thinking, this could be the start of something really big.
Then you want number 3, right?
Oh, without a doubt. Go get it.
They'll start the drive with a run by Gordon. A short gain of just over 2 yards as the first half clock dips inside of 3 minutes.
Brought down at the 28-yard line.
Now a 10th carry for Melvin Gordon. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down. They'll run on first down. Gordon. Dorian O'Daniel, third-round pick in 2018, made the tackle.
46-yard line. It's a gain of 5.
Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. He's going to take off with it. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
3 yards the gain there, second down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
3-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 7 at the Chiefs' 41-yard line.
On second down, they'll run with Gordon. And he'll work free from 1 tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain 1 or 2 short here with 3rd down coming up. On play action, they'll throw. This is caught, and he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Jerry Jeudy, 36 yards. And the Broncos push further out in front. Well, you know he can be explosive, and he's ultra-explosive there on the fly route.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches and we've had quoted back to us, well, you know something? When you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's coming or not. But sometimes athleticism beats you as well. He just took off and went. And that's almost like one of your turkey bowl games, isn't it? Just go long,
backyard,
man. I'll hit you. And it worked really well for them.
The kickoff for Denver.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And the mile high air in full effect as that's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And now here comes Kansas City. And you're under a minute to go in the half, a first half that hasn't been particularly kind to you. How do you think they'll play this?
Well, I think the smart approach is to run out the clock, lick your wounds at the half, and see if you can come up with a strategy to play better in the second. But it's also something to challenging your offense right here. You know, hey, guys, you help dig this hole. See if you can get us out of it a little bit before the half runs out. Let's go make some plays.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. Got a man open. It's Ricky Seals-Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Complete. The tight end, Kelce. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. The tight end, Kelce, has it over the middle. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
The Chiefs field goal. A 46-yard attempt.
So it's on to halftime in this AFC divisional round matchup. As we send you on out to our studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. This, the first of four divisional round matchups coming up this weekend. We'll get back out to you guys in just a moment. But first, let's take a look ahead to tomorrow's other divisional round games in the AFC. And it looks like a good one, as it'll be the Baltimore Ravens doing battle with the Cleveland Browns. Meanwhile, in our game, we've got one half remaining to find out who goes on to the AFC title game. And to bring it all to you, let's send it back out to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three.
Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
Winner go home, that's the name of the game, and we're back underway with the second half of this AFC divisional round. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll hand this to Williams to start things out. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. The big man, Jarrell Casey, in on the stop. They had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. They run it again with Williams. He finds an opening past the 40. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. A gain there of 30 big ones.
Well, partner, I have to say they caught him in the right defense there. Nickel set, fifth defensive back on the field, and they love to run against that because now you typically get a bigger blocker on a smaller defender.
Yeah, because those DBs like you, they want the interception. They're not as worried about the running play, right?
Not at all. And I still remember being in school, and one of my offensive line teammates used to say, boy, I'd love to come down if you hit you little people.
Good run there.
Kansas City.
Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. To the right side, it's Kelce. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
On the pickup, brings up
2 yards left on second down from the nine. They'll run out of the gun here, Williams. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line.
Short of the goal line.
So a decent deficit at this stage in the second half, four down territory?
No doubt about it. There's not a chance that he hasn't looked ahead and said, okay, if we gain yardage on this play, this is what we'll do going forward. If we lose yardage, this is the play call that I'll have ready.
From the gun, it's Mahomes. This is caught by Hill for a Chiefs touchdown.
Number 10, Tyreek Hill.
A 1 yard touchdown pass. And the Chiefs are able to draw a bit closer.
First and goal. Forget running the football. Forget establishing anything. Just put it in the end zone with the pass for a touchdown.
Well, yeah, I guess that's the definition of catching the defense off guard there. They weren't expecting that.
And that totally goes against type, doesn't it? When you think first and goal from the one, you're thinking running play.
Hamler now to return it. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21.
The Broncos take over first and 10.
Denver offense at the line, ready to go. Their lead down to two scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a first and 10. Oh, he'll air this one deep for Judy. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there, almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. He'll try and run it. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a first down.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
That time he was looking for Jerry Jeudy, and it's second down. Second and 10 here as we sit in the third quarter of this divisional round matchup. Dancing to his left, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Quarterback taken down and sacked. An 8-yard loss on the play. It's now third down.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. Got a man open. It's Sutton. And he gets this only to the 41. Not near enough for the first. They do get 9, but it leads to fourth down. They're going to try and throw. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
KC's offense ready to take over. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
The All-Pro Von Miller there on the tackle.
Brings up second and 10. At the 41-yard line.
Again, it's Williams. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain that time, and it leaves him with third and 11 coming up.
And it's third down.
From the gun on third down, Mahomes looking for his running back, and he's got him. And a pretty nice tackle there, ranging up from his free safety spot as he'll stop him about a yard short. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for fourth down. And that hits the right upright and caroms away. It's no good. One quarter remains for the right to advance to the AFC title game. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And now first downs are key. They want to keep that clock moving, up by two scores as they try to cement their place in the conference championship round in 1 week's time. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. The escapability in evidence there is that one. Good for 15 and a first. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. He'll fire one downfield for, and this is caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Noah Fant, 36 yards. And the Broncos will extend their lead.
So, my man, another touchdown. They're looking like the number one seed that they earned throughout the year. Looking pretty dominant right now.
We knew the road to the Super Bowl would run right through this stadium. Somebody's going to have to come in here and beat these guys. Good luck. I don't think it's happening this weekend.
No, definitely not this weekend. And for anyone else out there, bring your game.
Buyer beware.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. Their hopes of advancing past this divisional round hanging by a thread, if that, as they begin here with a first and 10 on the wrong side of the scoreboard. Caught, Kelce, left side. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a three-yard gain there. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Here's second and 7 now from the 28. Working from the gun, Mahomes completes it to Hardman. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Roughing the passer, defense.
Everybody stay under control. Let's just make plays, man.
Well, they'll get the yardage, but they hate to see him take that hit.
You're always trying to cool off a big-time guy throwing the ball, but you have to know when to back off, pull up, and not hit him. There's the penalty.
First and 10, here's Mahomes. Open man is Hill, he's got it.
Mahomes pass.
It'll be a gain of 6, and it'll bring up a second down.
It's a pickup of 6.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Now here's Mahomes. He'll drop this down to Williams. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
And a first down, Chiefs.
Mahomes now on first down. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
It's a gain of 9.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and 1. Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. This will be caught just inside the 10. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They've got it first and goal as they look to punch in a late score. And again, it's Mahomes. Yeah, he's got it. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Chiefs are able to cut into this lead.
And that touchdown puts us in a position to have a discussion, doesn't it? Now, it'll be a 2-score game after the conversion.
Yeah, I mean, there's no doubt with a 2-score game, they're going to have to onside kick it. We'll just see if they've got a miracle up their sleeve.
And you wonder what onside kicks they're going to use and in what sequence if they hope to have a chance to win this game.
And the Broncos are going to get the football. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Look to throw here. Open man, he completes it to Judy. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Flush to his right. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Gotta give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and give some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arms down.
Incomplete.
He'll definitely say that that's one he should have held on to. But when you're playing in elements like this, sometimes those bullet passes, those ones with a little bit of pace on them, they can be difficult to hold on to.
That is caught at the 7-yard line. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play.
And this is caught for a Bronco touchdown. Deshaun Hamilton there to make the grab. And the Broncos will add on to their lead.
Well, there's just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking it into the end zone. And you know they could have taken a knee there, but they decided to play this one all the way out. And I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee now, we're actually showing you disrespect that way, like taking pity on you. They're not about to do that to their opponent.
The point after, no gimme in the snow, but it's up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now.
Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Patrick Mahomes on his way out for their next drive. And after the slow start, the numbers show he has really straightened things out. How often sometimes is that you come into a game and the defense is game planned a little differently than you expected?
More often than maybe people realize, so adjustments are often a big part of each and every game, and it's not just getting that.
He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. Von Miller, credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. Gets this one to Hill. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. He's got his man. That's Hardman. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. The Broncos going to continue on as we say so long, everybody, and thanks for watching. For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. The Broncos are winners as we say so long from Denver.
Trying to keep the people stable the way I feel. I might it all up the way you feel. You might do it for the buck. All black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go and water down the devil. Listen to everything around me. I can't see. You picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee rolling thunder. Don't hear my cry. Don't let alibi splash if I finally starting to realize. Never give up and coincide. I can't watch TV. It's all a lot. Time to try and go ahead and fly. Everybody want a straight answer, but media keep us blind. A good heart is not hard to find. Why do people try to define infrastructure? I don't got time. Infrastructure, I don't got time. I could. Alter. We're talking about your brother protecting themselves and daughters from political mislaughter.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for my kingdom, get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Now
never play by the rules. Guess I'm paying my dues. They gon' try to intrude. Poison the multitude. They be quick to accuse. When you got different views, just know you gon' pay the price. Best up by item you choose.
Many ties in the culture. Hit you with MK Ultra. I knew you was a vulture. Holy Ghost, get the ushers. No, I can't trust you. Shock you, deny you, fluster. Crashing down, I was cluttered. Doing it so subtle. Falling out through the rubble. Remember this in jungle. The top, I was gonna get something. The middle, gotta stay hunting. Why the rush up for nothing? 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 Agitated illusion. Only built for confusion. The institution. Modern day execution. Think I know the solution. Maybe not should I do it. Just put it in the music. Just put it in the music.
Someone put me out, cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my dream.